As a signatory to the United Nations Conventions, including the Stockholm and Basel Convention, Uganda adheres to international environmental regulations. The Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants, implemented in 2001, banned the production of polychromated phosphate.
Transformers have a chemical that cools them as they work. So it is a coolant in transformers. It has been phased out, and the new transformers don't come with it, but old transformers used to have this chemical. So it is harmful to people, and we need to phase it out. You will find that if you have followed the energy sector, some people go and remove transformer oil for cooking. This is the kind of oil that we are talking about. When it goes into human body, it is very harmful.
In 2019, Uganda domesticated this ban through the National Environment Act by listing polychromated phosphate on prohibited and restricted chemicals with 2025 a deadline of elimination. Uganda is one of the countries that have been selected by the Basel, Rotterdam and Stockholm Convention Secretariat to pilot safe elimination of these chemicals. As part of the pilot project, studies will be conducted on all transformers to ascertain the purification of the chemicals before devising the way forward.
Is to develop and validate the national inventory to identify how much PCBs Uganda has. And that will be a first step to work towards eliminating those PCBs. What are the main challenges? Well, as you know, the energy production and distribution throughout the country implicates many different stakeholders. There are different companies that are owning this contaminated equipment. So one of the main challenges is to really identify which equipment contains PCB. And for that, we will need to build capacity of the technicians and the workers that will take the samples to analyze this PCB. A second challenge, of course, would be determining the content of PCBs. For that, we will need specialized laboratories that can analyze through different techniques the content and determine how much PCBs are on those samples. And finally, to complete this inventory, of course, we will need information from the different regions.
As part of the pilot project, studies will be conducted on all transformers to ascertain the proliferation of the chemicals before devising the way forward. However, lack of sufficient human capital and non-sustainable financing models were identified as some of the challenges towards the elimination of the dangerous chemicals.
Under the Stockholm Convention, there is what they call a financial mechanism. Now, under this financial mechanism, the Global Environmental Facility, which is based in Washington, is the facility which provides financing for dealing with all aspects that are under the Stockholm Convention. So aspects such as PCB management, inventories, temporary storage, and disposal are financed under this framework. So the Global Environmental Facility. Now, the Global Environmental Facility, as entities or institutions that they work with directly, as intermediaries, and these intermediaries are referred to as implementing agencies. So there's UNIDO, there's UNDP, and Africa Development Bank, among others.
This is expected to be addressed by findings of the workshop. A baseline study conducted in 2008 indicated that about 13% of the transformers in the country contained the dangerous chemicals. Since then, no conclusive study has been undertaken to determine the chemical proliferation among the electricity equipment.